大家好, it's time for another episode of Growing Up with Chinese. 欢迎收看今天的成长汉语. Thanks for joining us today. Last time we talked about making phone calls in Chinese. Today, we're going to be focusing on transportation. Now, in the United States, along with many other countries, when kids live too far away from school, they have the option of taking a school bus. Now, most public schools in China do not offer this service, but that's mostly because China has quite a developed public transportation system. Take Beijing, for example. There's the subway, public buses, taxis. There are even bike lanes on most every road so that people can bike virtually anywhere. So today, Xiaoming and Mike are making their way to school. Let's see how that evolves.
Mike， 快起床，我们睡够了。
啊？现在几点了？
都七点半了，快点。
小明，你平时怎么去学校？
我平时先坐公交车，再到地铁。不过今天太晚了。我们打车去吧。师傅，你去七十四中学。
对不起，我不太认识，你能帮我指路吗？
好的，您先直行。到长安街十字路口再向右转。
好的。
哎，怎么这么堵啊？
我给你们停地铁站吧，坐地铁会快一点。
好的，谢谢您。麦克，这是地铁一号线，咱们可以到东单站转五号线。
啊，哎呀，快点来车吧。
Oh no, it's never nice when you sleep in by mistake, especially if you have to be somewhere at a specific time. But Xiaoming was definitely full of ideas on different ways to get to school. Let's take a look at some of what was said. Mike, 快起床，我们睡过头了。Mike, quick get up, we've overslept. 睡过头 is the phrase overslept. 你平时怎么去学校？How do you usually get to school? 平时 usually or typically. 怎么 in this case makes it a question functioning as how. 去学校 get to school or go to school. 你平时怎么去学校？
麦克，快起床，我们睡够了。
啊？现在几点了？
都七点半了，快点。
你平时怎么去学校？
我平时先坐公交车。I usually take the bus first, 再倒地铁, and then switch to the subway. There's a sentence pattern here. 先 something, 再 something. First something, and then something. We'll go over this pattern in just a bit. 倒means to switch or change. So, 我平时先坐公交车。I usually take the bus first, 再倒地铁, and then switch to the subway.
小明，你平时怎么去学校？
我平时先坐公交车，再到地铁。不过今天太晚了，我们打车去吧。
对不起，我不太认识，你能帮我指路吗？I'm sorry, I don't know where that is. Can you give me directions? 指路 is to give directions, but it literally means to point the road. If you point the road, or point out the way, you're giving directions, right?
师傅，你去七十四中学。
对不起，我不太认识，你能帮我指路吗？
好的，您先直行，到长安街十字路口再向右转。
好的。
哎，怎么这么堵啊？
我给你们停地铁站吧，坐地铁会快一点。
好的，谢谢您。
咱们可以坐到东单站转五号线。We can take this line to Dongdan Station and then switch to line 5. 转 means to turn or switch. It comes up twice today, actually. One is in the context of turn right, 右转, and the other is in this sentence, 转五号线, switch to line 5.
Mike, 这是地铁一号线，咱们可以到东单站转五号线。
啊，哎呀，快点来车吧。
Everyone, let's check out what we have lined up for today's vocabulary. Okay, first off, let's take a look at some specific vocabulary. 怎么? Used to inquire about nature, condition, cause, etc. And another meaning is how. 怎么? 晚, late. 晚. 坐. Travel by bus.Train, plane, etc. 坐 到 arrive, reach. Used as the complement of a verb indicating the result of an action. 到 学校 school, 学校公交车 public bus, 公交车地铁 subway, metro. 地铁 Today, we're going to be looking at the radical for dirt, or earth. It's in two of our vocabulary words today, 地 of 地铁 and 坐. So, let's take a look at these two characters. Whoops, wonder where that came from. 地And 坐 Now, we've seen a radical at the top of a character. You all still remember the bamboo radical, right? Well, we find the dirt radical on the left in 地 and on the bottom in 坐 Now, the actual character for dirt or earth is 土, and it looks like this. So, quite similar between all three. Then you can see, really, it doesn't change much depending on whether it's on the left or the bottom or on its own. Now, the character for D on its own means ground. Now, ground certainly does have a lot of dirt in it, doesn't it? Okay, let's look at 坐. In today's context, 坐 is used to indicate travel by some mode of transportation. But it also happens to have the meaning of sit or to sit. Now, if you think about it, you usually sit when you travel. So, 坐 having these two meanings makes a lot of sense, really. Now, check this out. This here, let me switch a color, is the character for person, 人, right? So, we can see that 坐, this character, is made up of two people, and the character for dirt or earth. So there are two people sitting on the ground. And the character means sit. Fun, isn't it? All right, time to move from transportation and high-speed trains over to some language points. Let's take a look at what we have lined up for today. 怎么? 你平时怎么去学校? How do you usually get to school? 怎么 is used to ask how. It comes before a verb, which in this case is 去, to go somewhere. So some examples of this pairing are 怎么说, how to say. 怎么想, how do you think, or what do you think. 怎么写, how to write. Today, though, we are asking how to get to school, which is 怎么去学校.
哎呀, 这道题太难了。 怎么做啊?
你自己想想吧,我也不太会。
Here's an important pattern, but thankfully, it's not too difficult. 先, dot, 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 再, dot, dot, dot. First, and then. 我平时先坐公交车。 I usually take the bus first, 再倒地铁, and then switch to the subway. 先 is quite easy to use. It means first in the context of a series of actions. 再 functions like and then. I wash my face first, and then I go to bed. 我先洗脸再睡觉. 再 implies that the first action has finished or will finish before the next action takes place. Now, after all, you can't wash your face and sleep all at the same time, right? Well, maybe some people can, but in any case, the pattern we're looking at here is 先 something something 再 something something.
小明吃饭了。妈妈，我正在写作业。哦，放假喽。小明，我们明天先去划船，再去看电影，怎么样？太好了，兰兰。
我都等不及了。咱们,
咱们 is equivalent to 我们 or us, but it has a slightly more specific meaning. 咱们 includes the speaker and the listener or listeners. And it's mostly used in spoken Chinese as opposed to written Chinese. 咱们, us.
今天天气真暖和，咱们去放风筝吧。可是
今天一点风都没有，怎么放风筝啊？
小明，你们知道吗？ 我考了全年级第一。是吗？
你真是咱们班的骄傲啊！
Congratulations, everyone. We're just about done for the day. 咱们先看一封信，再说再见，好吗？ Let's first look at a letter and then say goodbye, okay? Now, we have a letter today from Ellen of the USA, who was kind enough to send in a joke related to Chinese. It's a play on words. Okay, here it goes. Quack, quack. Quack, quack. Quack, quack. Do you know what that is? It's a Peking duck. Not a Peking duck, as in Beijing duck, but Peking. A Peking duck. Okay, thanks for your joke, Ellen. Please keep your thoughts and comments or jokes coming our way. I really do love hearing from all of you. 谢谢你们的收看. Thanks for tuning in to today's show. See you all next time. 加油, everyone. 再见.